In a previous video, we took a look at Hornady's cam lock bullet puller, and while it worked well enough with small caliber bullets, the fact is that it still struggled with larger diameters like 45 ACP due to its poorly designed collet system. This week, we're going to check out a comparable bullet puller manufactured by RCBS. One of the first things you'll notice about the RCBS version is that instead of the wimpy plastic tube that Hornady ships their cam lock puller system in, the RCBS model comes in a spacious plastic hard case large enough to store your collets. The actual device looks and feels quite a bit sturdier as well. Consisting of only two separate pieces, including the body and collet, this bullet puller is the definition of simple. Just as a quick note here, as with Hornady's system, the RCBS bullet puller does not include collets, so you'll need to purchase those separately, one per caliber. So how exactly does it work? Basically, when the handle is turned, a threaded rod inside the body pulls up on the collet, causing its pedals to close and grip the bullet. When the handle's loosened again, the pressure dissipates and the pedals expand to release it. Setup is an absolute breeze. We'll begin by keeping the collet stationary while spinning the bullet puller handle. This causes a threaded rod inside the body to disengage from the collet, allowing us to remove it. Next, we'll grab the collet we've selected, in this case a 45 ACP, and thread it into the body. With that done, we'll turn the handle until it's nice and snug, and we're ready to install the whole unit into a single stage press. Okay, so next we'll insert a cartridge into the shell plate of our press, and raise the ram so that the bullet enters the collet without actually touching the cartridge casing. Now we simply turn the bullet puller's handle until we feel the pedals tighten down on the bullet. It's very hard for me to describe this properly as it's just something you have to feel, but what we're looking for here is tight enough to grip the bullet securely without crushing it or marring its surface. It may take you a couple of tries, but the good news here is that the superior collet construction means there's very little risk of breaking it if you over-tighten. With that done, we'll lower the ram, and as you can see, the cartridge casing pulls away from the bullet smoothly. It takes a bit of practice, but once you've got the pressure worked out, this actually becomes a very easy tool to use for disassembling cartridges with a minimum of fuss. As with the Hornady model, it's worth noting RCBS's bullet puller doesn't do very well with cast lead bullets. However, that's just the reality of collet-based systems. What really makes the RCBS bullet puller stand out from the competition is its high-quality collets. Whereas the Hornady collets feature almost comically thin pedals prone to breaking, particularly in large calibers, RCBS's are thick and sturdy and will last a lifetime. As an example, here are a couple of Hornady's 45 caliber collets. As you can see, one of them is chipped and broken. This happened after just a couple uses, and although Hornady did replace it free of charge, it's still pretty disappointing. By contrast, take a look at this RCBS collet. This 45 caliber collet will never chip or break thanks to the thick pedals used in its construction. Compare the two, and I think you'll agree that the RCBS design is vastly superior. The only real complaint that I have about the RCBS bullet puller is one that's true of all collet-based systems, and that's that it doesn't do very well with cast lead bullets. When it comes right down to performance, the fact is the RCBS bullet puller does everything the Hornady does and more. Since I purchased my RCBS, I've never used the Hornady again, and frankly, I doubt if I ever will.